located at Garage 7 about her issues, what's going on. Southbound back up to 60, northbound from 105, located about Rosemary.
This report is sponsored by the Auto Club of Southern California. Did you know the Auto Club offers competitive rates on auto insurance? Go to AAA.com/insurance for a free quote today and find out how much you can save. Insurance for the Auto Club. Visit AAA.com/insurance today.
That's what I call a
501c3 charity organization, so you'll receive a maximum tax deduction. What's more, you'll receive a vacation voucher of 3 days and 2 nights. Also on the web at carsofficial.com.
1-877-CARS-FICKET. Donate your car today.
We have a lot to celebrate this holiday season, but COVID-19 hasn't gone away. So let's make sure to keep our celebration safer by following these tips. Get vaccinated to protect loved ones, and get a booster to keep your immunity strong. Wear a mask in all public indoor settings, and if possible, keep gathering small, short, and outdoors if you're uncertain of everyone's vaccination status. Bring on the cheer safely this year. Find a vaccine near you at myturn.ca.gov. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
Was the night before Christmas, and someone in your house was tossing and turning like an insomniac mouse.
The children were nestled, all snug in their bed, while the lumps in your mattress filled you with dread.
When out of the radio there arose such a clatter, it was me screaming free, not some quiet pitter-patter.
To sit and sleep you should go, for the best gift of all, a great night's sleep for once and for all.
It's Sit and Sleep's year-end clearance sale. Save up to 50% off all the best brands. Plus, with your good credit, get 0% financing for 24 months with your minimum monthly payment and a $300 gift with any Tempur-Pedic purchase.
And unlike gifts that are too big or too small, our exclusive bed mesh technology scientifically fits you with just the right mattress.
A bundle of beds he had flung in his pack to soothe and relieve your aching back.
And I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Trust your sleep to Sit and Sleep into all a good night."
Thanks for calling Toyota. This is Jan.
Hey, Jan. Toyota's on. Is it on?
It is. Now's the time to find year-end deals on Camry, RAV4, the all-new Tundra, and more.
Great. You know what this means?
That you can save big on our most popular models?
Totally. But also, it's officially the holidays. Fire up the chestnuts, kids!
I'm not sure I follow.
People are drinking pumpkin spice coffee during summer. Radio stations blast holiday playlists in October. I truly have lost all meaning.
So you base your family's holiday schedule around Toyotathon?
Bingo. Toyotathon comes around like clockwork. How else will we know it's time to celebrate?
That actually makes a lot of sense.
Now, if I can only figure out when to take down the light.
Toyotathon is on. Stop by a participating dealer today.
Dealer inventory varies. Offers are subject to change throughout Toyotathon, which ends on January 3rd. See your participating Toyota dealer for details. Toyota, let's go places.
I am one of thousands of women with metastatic breast cancer or MBC.
Which is breast cancer that spreads to other parts of the body.
I am Vivian Limoy and taking iBranch, prostacyclin.
iBranch 125 milligram tablet with an aromatase inhibitor is for postmenopausal women or for men with HR-positive, HER2-negative MBC as the first hormonal-based therapy.
Be in your life. Ask your doctor about iBranch and visit iBranch.com. iBranch may cause low white blood cell counts that may lead to serious infection. iBranch may cause severe inflammation of the lungs. Both of these can lead to death. Tell your doctor right away if you have new or worsening symptoms, including trouble breathing, shortness of breath, cough, or chest pain. Before taking iBranch, tell your doctor if you have fever, chills, or other signs of infection, liver or kidney problems, are or plan to become pregnant, or are breastfeeding. Common side effects include low red blood cell and old platelet counts, infections, tiredness, nausea, sore mouth, abnormalities in liver blood tests, diarrhea, hair thinning or loss, vomiting, rash, and loss of appetite.
Under the current municipal code,
you cannot drink alcohol on any public street, in a restroom, a beach, a park, a parking lot.
But the code does not specify the city council chambers.
I think it would go better if you had a glass or two of wine.
Gary and Janet, weekdays at 10 a.m.
I think you
advice or counsel person to your colleagues.
On KFI.
Have I done it correctly?
Yes.
It's the best time of the year. Now, I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer.
And good morning, Bill Handel. On a Monday morning, December 20th, this morning crew, hold again. Snap continues. If you go to the supermarket, you probably are aware that we are in the biggest era of inflation since, well, 40 years ago. Inflation hasn't been this high. So it's a long time. I mean, can you imagine 40 years ago is when inflation was this bad? So anybody who is, I guess, up until 45, maybe 50, maybe 55, has no idea what inflation. Okay, let's set up this one. The government is primed for a crackdown on excessive food inflation, food price inflation. And why? Well, just look at the cost of food. Gone to the supermarket and looked for meat, high-quality meat. I went to Costco yesterday or Saturday, what a shocker. And they sell prime. Beef as well as choice beef. And I was looking at a prime roast at $25 a pound, and it's a big honking roast, and I looked at the entire price, and it's $355. Who the hell buys a roast for $355? I mean, it's a big one, you feed a lot of people, but $355? And by the way, that's prime. Choice is half that. But the point is, if you look at the cost of meat, it's astronomical. The cost of chicken, the cost of pork, the cost of produce, the cost of perishables, cereal, I mean, all of it has gone up. And why? Well, supply chain issues, of course, we know that, bottlenecks. However, if you look at the actual figures, there is X inflation at the manufacturing, at, of course, distribution, at the market. It costs more for everything. However, if you look at the supermarket, they're way ahead of inflation. I mean, they've taken advantage of just the shortage and the anxiety, and inflation feeds on itself. So you change your life. You're not going to have steaks twice a week. You're going to have it once a week, or not at all. You're going to go to chicken. And you're going to go to simply less quality protein and not even eat as much as you have. Certainly you're not driving as much as you have. You're keeping those leisure drives to a minimum with $4.70. Yeah. And as you know, I'm looking at an electric car. Just can't get any. Literally can't get the car. And you know that. You've tried that yourself. So the markets are being blamed for simply being hoarse. And if you look at the stats, and you look at the market system that we have, hey, they're charging what they're charging, and if you don't like it, don't buy there. And when people don't buy, guess what happens? There's a surplus, they don't make as much money. I mean, that's their position. We're not doing anything that a good business model would not do. And Elizabeth Warren, God bless her, Elizabeth Warren wrote a letter to the major supermarkets, Kroger, Albertsons, Publix, and shared the letter publicly, and started with, and I'll do this for the last today, okay? This would never happen in a real communist country, you bastards. And said outright, you're taking advantage of inflation and just adds greater burden. If you look at the stats, you bet. 2020, supermarkets saw sales increase by 11%. 2020, inflation was nowhere near 11%. Matter of fact, right now, it's the highest in 40 years, 6.9%. And what these stores are doing also, this is a big controversy. Instead of raising wages, what they're doing is buying back their stock. They take extra money, or whatever money they want to spend, assuming they have cash, and buy their own stock on the market, which means there's less stock out there, which means the company is more valuable and the value of the company goes up. They actually buy their way into a more valuable company. Oh boy, does that help. It's been going on all over the place. I mean, the stock buybacks are going like crazy because companies have so much cash. And the White House says, okay, we're going to stop this, and is using what tools it has, I don't know what those tools are, to crack down on some of the bad behavior and citing a lot of evidence, for example, that meat processors, buy the meat, process it, and send it out to the stores, are putting out price increases way above the cost they're incurring due to inflation. Antitrust law provides remedies to prevent extreme concentration of the White House system or abuse of market power. It's just not happening. No, it is happening. But it's the American model. I mean, what do? You put on, actually put on limits? We did that when inflation was completely out of control. Nixon, if you remember, started the WIN program, or it could have been George. It could have been. It could have been the vice president. And so he became president. Therefore, became the president. And it was WIN with inflation now. Where are these buttons? Nixon started. And limited. That's it. You're done. Can't raise prices. Can't raise wages. Everything is exactly the same. So does it go on forever? It does not. So it was controlled. And inflation was controlled. Well, we were in hyperinflation at the time. Inflation was controlled. How? Because if prices stay the same, if wages don't increase, guess what? Inflation doesn't exist. And then the student has the program ended. And in that second, wages and prices blew up to where the market level sits. And that's the problem the Feds are trying to do. You can't artificially put limits. If it's legal, unless you change the law and saying it is not legal to make more than X percent profit, boy, let me tell you how crazy Americans would go for that one. You own your own business, you can only make 12% profit. You go to a corporation, can only make 12% profit or 8%. And the rest of it has to be invested. If there's anything above that, there's extra cash above that, you don't pay dividends. You don't give extra compensation to your CEO and higher management. You have to pay the wage earner, the workers, the union workers, non-union workers. You have to pay them all the rest of the money. Well. Okay, welcome to an America that isn't America. And I think the market's going to control it. Well, I eat steak 3 times a week, not anymore. And you have certain fast food outlets that are just throwing things off the menu. You've seen that? Those are limited now. That means those products they don't buy. Coming up. Decriminalizing drugs as overdoses climb. And how long have we been talking about decriminalizing drugs? How long have I been talking about decriminalizing drugs? Well, it's actually really happening city to city, state to state. And where else? Where do you think the leadership is coming from in that and governmental moves towards it? I'll explain when we come back. KFI AM 640, let's check in with Jennifer.
The average price for gas in the U.S. has dropped by 6 cents over the past few weeks to $3.41 per gallon. We should be so lucky in California. AAA says the average price for a gallon of gas in the Golden State is $4.67. The average price in L.A. is a cent higher at $4.68 a gallon. News is brought to you by Rooter Hero. A man's been arrested in Colorado on suspicion of killing a teenage girl in San Francisco more than 4 decades ago.
San Francisco police say 76-year-old Mark Personette was arrested this week in connection with the 1978 death of Marissa Hardy. The 15-year-old girl from New York was visiting the city when her body was found in a park. Police said detectives used the best available technology at the time and exhausted every lead, but the probe went cold. In October 2020, they reopened the case and determined Personette to be a suspect using advanced investigative methods. Detectives say Personette may be a suspect in other unsolved homicides involving young women. Mark Bronner, KFI News.
Police in Pennsylvania are warning about a scam involving the money transfer app Zelle. Investigators say scammers are sending out text messages that are telling people they need to reset their Zelle passwords. The criminals then call the account owners and pretend to be from the bank fraud department to get their personal information. Israel has banned travel to the U.S. because of the recent increase in COVID cases.
The new measure will go into effect at midnight on December 22nd and means that all travel from Israel to the U.S. will be banned. Israeli citizens returning to Israel from the U.S. will have to go into quarantine, even if vaccinated.
ABC's Inez de la Cutera says Israel's also banned travel to Canada, Germany, Italy, and six other countries. And a typhoon has killed more than 200 people in the Philippines. Officials say there are also hundreds of people who are hurt and dozens more are missing. The typhoon hit the country late last week with wind gusts up to 160 miles an hour, which is the equivalent of a Category 5 hurricane. The storm caused major flooding and landslides. Power has also been knocked out to many areas. We've got your drive on the 5.
I can't imagine that kind of wind, that's for sure. All right, you're headed towards Anaheim, going through now. Southbound Cobb at Disney Way. Right lane was blocked there for a little bit. That should get over to the right shoulder for a quick there, I think. However, if you're coming down approaching the 91, it's going to be slow from the 91 down that direction. The only time's pretty good until you get to the 605. Now, here's the issue for the morning. Listen up. 605 between the I-5 and the 60 in big trouble. Going through Whittier. 605 at Washington. We've got lanes blocked on both sides of the freeway. Southbound back up from the 10, northbound from the 91. That's getting quite serious. Now, the 710 is okay. It's not wide open, but a lot better than between 91 and the I-5. Rosemead Boulevard for the 605 traffic coming out of the south is a pretty good choice. Baldwin Park, some good news, finally. West Bend at the 605. The crash is gone. Coming off Kellogg, it's going to be slow from Massachusetts towards about Francisquito. After that, you're back on the gas pedal. A good drive there. KFI in the sky. Hope to get you there faster. I'm Jeff Ball.
The Lakers lost to the Chicago Bulls, 115-110. They had to play without Anthony Davis, who'll be out at least 4 weeks with a knee injury, and without head coach Frank Vogel, who's on the COVID protocol list. The Clippers set the San Antonio Spurs at 7:30 this evening, live on AM 570 LA Sports. In hockey, the Kings came from behind to beat the Washington Capitals thanks to Adrian Kempe in the third period.
Here's Kempe moving in. Kempe to the net, he scores! Adrian Kempe gives the Kings the lead! 3-2 in Washington.
And 3-2 the final score as well. I'm Wayne Resnick, KFI Sports.
Does CBD work? Over 90% of doctors said their patients have used CBD to treat health conditions. When 9 out of 10 patients use CBD, that speaks volumes for how safe and effective CBD can be. My wife gets the full spectrum CBD, calms her down. She loves it. I also love it. Here's what patients tell their doctors they love about CBD. 90% of CB distillery customers said they sleep better with CBD. 80% of customers said CBD helps with discomfort after physical activity. And if you're looking for a little peace of mind and calm these days, you'd be wise to explore CBD. If you haven't discovered the powers of CBD, you're missing it. Go to CBDistillery.com where you order online with no prescription required. And enter Tim in the promo code for 20% off. That's right. Enter Tim at CBDistillery.com for 20% off. CBDistillery.com. Not available in Idaho, Iowa, or South Dakota.
Here's SoCal weather from KFI. Partly cloudy today. Highs will just be in the 60s. More of the same tomorrow, but a few more clouds will come in. And then our next chance at rain comes in Wednesday. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee.
Hi, we're Hulk. Meet Dr. Daryl Perlstein. He's a thoracic surgeon at the Hogue Family Cancer Institute who loves the outdoors and hiking. He's also a leader in robotic-assisted surgery, who trains other surgeons nationwide. Dr. Perlstein would love to get to know you, and is ready to make a positive difference in your family's life. Get to know Hogue. Visit HogueHealth.org and find your physician today.
Living with someone who tested positive for COVID-19 in the past 5 days? Those 18 and over who are not vaccinated may be able to take part in a clinical trial for a possible medication to prevent COVID-19. This trial is not for a vaccine, and participation is voluntary. Participants will receive study-related care at no cost and may receive reimbursement for study-related time and travel. To learn more, call 844-461-1936. That's 844-461-1936. Sponsored by Merck.
can you believe the holidays are almost here? When you think about that, what's the first thing that comes to mind? For me, it's the smiling faces of friends and family as we celebrate together. And now we bring this to Centennial, America's number one designer and installer of elegant outdoor living systems. Today, I'd like to help bring a smile to you and your loved ones' faces, too. For a limited time, the city favorites are sharing out exclusive friends and family prices. This is your chance to say big on an outdoor makeover that will make every get-together more memorable than ever. From a new patio or fire pit to upgrading your driveway or entry, take advantage of the low prices during our Home for the Holidays Friends and Family Savings Award. Get started right now by calling 800-K004. That's 800-K004. Hurry, this exclusive Friends and Family pricing won't last forever. 800-K004 or systemfavors.com.
All orders must be placed by December 31st, and installation must commence within 60 days of sale. Financing subject to third-party approval. See website for full offer details. Contractor license 661575.
At Quiddon, or in Jubilee, call Jacob and Molly.
KFI AM 640.
iHeart Radio Station.
24 hour news. More stimulating talk.
Good morning. Handle here on a very cold Monday morning, December 20th. Senator Joe Manchin of West Virginia, ostensibly a Democrat, has just said no on the Build Back Better Act. President Biden's signature social program that went from $3.5 trillion down to $1.7 trillion, primarily because Joe Manchin insisted on it. He is, in fact, the negotiator. He's holding the cards. Well, he just slapped down the card and said, go fish, I win. So we already did a whole segment of that, but we'll continue talking about that one in the next couple of days. The issue of decriminalizing drugs. Wayne and I were having this discussion on the air a few days ago and talked about how much more it makes sense to simply start selling drugs. And drugs allowed to be sold, much like dispensaries do marijuana here in California and Colorado and Oregon and a few other states. But not just marijuana. I mean, extending that to fentanyl and heroin and opiates. Here you go. Just buy them. And maybe if you buy quality, pharmaceutical quality drugs, maybe you don't overdose. 100,000 opiate deaths this past year. Nothing's ever come close to it. And most of it was fentanyl, which is now on the market. Fentanyl didn't exist out there as a street drug until just a few years ago. And it's always been around in hospitals. I mean, I was given fentanyl when I was in an insane amount of pain after the surgery. They just use it. Water and other very powerful. And so governments are saying, all right, we've got to rethink how this all works. And a lot of it is happening in Canada. Toronto, for example, the largest city, is on the way to decriminalization because of this overdose epidemic. And so Toronto's Board of Health is going to seek permission from Canada's federal government, so that's how it works up there, to allow drug users to carry small amounts of drugs for personal use, including all of them. It wouldn't cover drug trafficking, so I guess they can buy it, but you can't buy it from anybody unless you set up a dispensary. Then you have Vancouver filed for the similar exemption in May, and then the entire province of British Columbia filed its application for decriminalizing in November. Oregon, last year, approved a plan to decriminalize drug possession. Last month, New York City became the first city in the U.S. to open supervised injection sites. Here's why. Because the model we're using simply doesn't work. And you had legislators who were convinced, we were fighting even the marijuana issue. They were fighting it. The marijuana is, quote, a gateway drug. Of course, it never started. So what they feared is what cities want to do now. Forget about just marijuana. Let's bypass marijuana and go right into opioids and fentanyl and all of those drugs. And why is that? Do they want people to become addicts? Of course not. Is it cheaper to deal with addicts? probably 100,000 overdose deaths. There are a lot of people dying. A lot of money. The criminalization has involved interdiction by the police coming in there. I mean, it is expensive stuff to deal with drug addiction. And as you look at it, and it's all there designed to stop addiction, to stop hospitalizations, to stop deaths, and the more money you spend, the bigger the problem is. And according to Dr. Davila, who is one of the directors of the program in Canada, the decriminalization lobby, Toronto spends $3 billion. In 2017, those are the last figures for drug loss. Overdose deaths, hospitalizations have simply increased dramatically. I mean, that's the only way out. There are people that think that, we don't want to deal with drugs. I mean, you have to. Look at it. You know, it's there in our face. You can't put your, I can't keep putting your head in the sand. And then you have the issue of the federal government. Remember, it's perfectly legal to go to a dispensary here in California. It is a violation of federal law. Dispensaries have been raided, shut down, and their inventory has simply been confiscated. And it's just now that banks have been given permission to deal with marijuana dispensaries. Because if it's illegal on a federal level, then it's illegal for banks to process transactions that involve any interstate commerce, which is every bank is covered by the FDIC. Okay, federal government controls it. Every bank has all kinds of regulations in terms of minimum reserves and parameters of which money can be lent or not. That's under federal jurisdiction. So guess what? As long as the marijuana is on a federal level illegal, that's a real problem, although they just loosened that up. So what's the answer? Like I've always said, there should be an aisle on Walmart simply saying drugs. Not the pharmacy. Right next to auto care, there should be the drug aisle. Everything from fentanyl to heroin to Percocet, Norco, right down the line. Is that going to help? Hell yeah, it's going to help. Cheaper, I think there are going to be far less opiate deaths. You know, when I really hurt, it's a pain in the ass to call my doctor and have him prescribe, and then go to the pharmacy. I'd rather just walk into a local store, the 7-Eleven, and pay more money for the drugs there. I regret it, but I'm willing to do that for the convenience. The research involving COVID-19, the medical research, and the medical papers that have been published. There's a story. And it's one of those hooks. Really? Yeah, really. I'll be back with that story when we come back.
Looks like Holiday Shoppers are paying the price for labor shortages this year. So there are 600 businesses. Since 33% of workers have quit their jobs in the past month, about a third of owners say they'd have to compensate by raising prices by an average 6%. Tiger Woods made a strong comeback in competitive golf with his son Charlie by his side. The pair finished second in the PNC Championship in Florida this weekend. John Daly and his son finished first. A teenager in Minnesota being called a hero jumped out of the McDonald's drive-thru window she was working to help a customer who was choking. The girl ran outside of the restaurant, got the woman out of her car, told the woman to her daughter to call 911. The 15-year-old then found a man nearby, asked him to perform the Heimlich maneuver, and just lobbed a chicken nugget that was stuck in the woman's throat. We got your drive on the 91 with Kfi Am in the sky next.
If you own a business and manage to keep five or more people on the payroll through the pandemic, there's a new government program that will pay you thousands of dollars per employee. And this is not a loan. This is a grant. The challenge is getting your hands on this money. This is a bureaucracy. InnovationRefunds.com cuts through the red tape, helps you get the cash. They do all the legwork. They don't charge a penny until you receive the money. And what they do is simply share a percentage of the money they get for you. They got my business a six-figure refund Now, their average client gets $250,000. That's impressive. Go to InnovationRefunds.com, click on the Qualify Me button, answer a few questions. InnovationRefunds.com, it's no risk, and it's certainly a high reward. InnovationRefunds.com, they help me, I'm sure they can help you. InnovationRefunds.com. Now through January 3rd, during the BMW Ultimate Road Home Sale, see a Southern California BMW Center for a credit of up to $2,500 on select models. Visit BMWUSA.com/roadhome for details.
Check out the from KFI, partly cloudy today, highs will be in the 60s. This report is brought to you by the Southern California BMW Centers. For checking the 91.
You bet the westbound drive now coming through the 71. Someday it'll be better. Not our lifetime, but someday. But it's real slow getting through. They want you to do that, though. It's a pretty good drive. Now, the rest of the 91, a little slow from the I-5 where it changes names there over to the Artesia Freeway, over to about Carmenita, and then things will finally improve, believe it or not, all the way up to the 110. Now, it's the 605 if you are just joining us. This is an early morning problem, and it's a big one. The 605 in Washington, that's about the halfway point between the I-5 and 60, and a long-run flash on both sides of the freeway. Southbound back up from the Globe 16, northbound from the 105. The 710, I keep talking about, it's getting busy, but actually, between the I-5 and the 105, you know, we got all lines open, traffic's actually moving. It's kind of slow, that's for sure. South of that, things are pretty good. And the northbound Harbor Freeway, it's getting kind of slow coming up from Manchester. So far, all lines open. Let's keep it that way, will you? They are flying the sky. I'll get you there faster. I'm Jeff Paul.
This report is sponsored by Wingstop. How's Wingstop sound? Crispy, tasty, and size. Juicy, boneless wings, soft and tossed in those 11 craveable flavors. Paired with hand-cut fries and Asian fried corn. Sounds good, doesn't it? Get it delivered at Wingstop.com.
Wealth isn't simply about money. It's more than just the numbers in your portfolio or your bank account. Wealth is all the everyday things that money enables you to do, the goals you have, the things you want to accomplish, and the life you want to live. Listen to Everyday Wealth with Sarah Adler Johnson, presented by Edelman Financial Engines. Each week, award-winning journalist Sarah Adler Johnson and personal finance expert Gene Chastain will explore how our financial decisions shape our everyday lives. They'll be joined by Edelman Financial Engine's wealth planners and other guests to demystify challenges like tax-efficient investing, retirement planning, and more. They'll share knowledge and tools to manage your finances today and build wealth for tomorrow. Join the conversation. Everyday Wealth airs each weekend and will be available on major podcast platforms. For airtime, visit everydaywealth.com.
In 1982, Melissa Tate identifies Rodney Lincoln as her mother's killer. Then in 2015, Melissa says Rodney didn't do it. On the Real Killer podcast, Leah Rothman reveals what may be a miscarriage of justice.
It was one of the most brutal crimes in St. Louis history. A single mother murdered, her two young daughters barely survived the attack. Her mom is named the Real Killer.
Listen to The Real Killer on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts.
Cash offers for used cars have never been higher, and selling your car has never been easier. And it's all because of Roto. That's R-O-D-O. Not only is Roto the best place to buy a new car, but you can also sell your used car or current vehicle lease to Roto for quick payment. Roto makes the process fast, fair, and transparent. So, sell your car on the Roto app or at Roto.com. That's R-O-D-O. The fastest way to sell your used car for more cash than ever before.
All right, let me tell you about Sunday. All right, my friends, it's Sunday. They can sell your home fast with no repairs, no hassle of showings, realtors, cleaning, or making upgrades. Sunday, they are the best, right? And they have a free no-obligation cash offer. They're going to visit your property, do a 3D walkthrough, and then package all the property details up, send it to thousands of local investors. And then over the next week, the average homeowner receives 12 offers on their property. It's like a mini bidding war going on your property. It's quick and easy, then they can close in as quick as 10 days. That means you can be out before Christmas. Maybe go up to Boise, Idaho, right? Buy a huge ranch up there. You may also be eligible for a $10,000 cash advance. So let's phone them up. 825-OFFER, 825-OFFER, or the website is sunday.com. FUNDAE.com. Send it to California Licensed Real Estate Broker, DR License Number 0208829.
This winter, we must all do our part to protect ourselves and loved ones from COVID-19. Getting vaccinated gives you the greatest protection against severe illness and death. And for the first time, everyone in the family ages 5 and up is eligible for the vaccine. If you are already fully vaccinated, get your booster to keep your immunity strong. Keeping each other safer is simple. Get vaccinated. Visit myterms.ca.gov to find a vaccination location near you. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
When I renovated my kitchen, I wanted to stay on budget and in control. So I found a contractor on House. That's H-O-U-Z-Z. The pro I hired on House provided an online project dashboard so I could track the budget, approve changes, get updates, and even see a project timeline. With a big renovation, that's really reassuring.
For a great home renovation experience, find the right pro for the job at House. That's H-O-U-Z-Z.
iHeartRadio is number one for music, radio, and podcasting all in one app, where you can always hear your favorite podcast free. Now it's time to celebrate those podcasts at our 2022 iHeartRadio Podcast Awards on January 13th. Vote for your favorite. iHeartPodcastAwards.com.
Audible is a proud sponsor of the Audible Audio Pioneer Award. Listen to the best of what you love with Audible Originals, audiobooks, podcasts, and more. True crime, sci-fi, memoirs, and wellness. Audible's got something for every mood. Try it for free when you sign up at audible.com.
You can tell where a Christmas party's going to be.
There's 20 or 30 cars all parked.
You can hear the music.
You can tell where the parties are.
They used to be they would want to rob a home that's unoccupied, so there's no witnesses. But what does that tell you? It doesn't matter if they're witnesses. No one's going to track them down. They'll never face trial.
John and Ken, weekdays at 2.
You just walk in, pull out your gun, rob everybody in sight, and bye.
On KFI.
I see the snowman. He's a jolly, happy soul. With a corn chop pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal.
And this is KFI AM 640 Handle Morning Crew, Monday, December 20th. And if you're in Pasadena or San Marino and live near the Alhambra Wash, stay inside. Because 800 to 1,000 gallons of gas from a gas station spilled into a storm drain, and you probably already know. And the big news is over the weekend, yesterday exactly, Democratic Senator Joe Manchin of West Virginia said there is a big no on the Build Back Better Act. Effectively, any negotiations. Joe Manchin killed it. And so now the Biden administration has to go back to step one. Question about medical research. Now, when you look at major publications, well-regarded publications, American Medical Association, Journal of the American Medical Association, English Lancet, which is on that same level, Journal of the American Pediatric Association, these are all legitimate high-end magazines. And when an article is published, generally peer-reviewed, looked at, edited, and very carefully allowed in to be published. Well, big problem when it comes to COVID studies. First of all, what I want to do is start this segment, we'll go into the next segment, with this simple premise, is that you have studies that go one way, hydroxychloroquine, for example, does nothing, and then there's some that go the other way. Hydroxychloroquine is the miracle drug, mainly because I think it got its, really got its push with President Trump. But here is the question. You have these studies that are published in major magazines, major medical journals, and then upon investigation, they're instantly retracted. Or sometime down the road, retract it. And basically, I get the same people that read June's issue and August issue. And here's what's going on. The pro-hydroxychloroquine crowd believes the benefit articles, believes those journal articles that say it's the best thing in the world, and then ignore the retraction. That's not real. The retraction is fake news. That hydroxychloroquine saves you. Nope, that's fake news. We believe that it saves you. See, look at the article. But it was retracted a month later. Doesn't matter. I'm going to believe that first article. Where did that come from? And when these studies that are published are looked at carefully, they're all crap. Nope. I want to believe the crap. Two problems here. One, you have a group of people that just will not agree to science unless it's published in their favor. I guess then science is okay. And two, journals, what were they doing publishing this when the evidence was out there? I mean, you can't just publish these findings, these studies, willy-nilly. There has to be some kind of investigation, which didn't happen. So that's the political take on that. And there's a scientific site, integrity site, they call Retraction Watch, which was founded in 2010. And what it does is, quote, act as a window into the scientific process and shining a light on academic research that has been retracted. That's their specialty. We'll look at the research of these studies that were published in major medical journals and then retracted. Let's take a look at what and how. And I will do that, and also the ivermectin. Oh, that's fantastic. That story, too. All of that coming up. This is KFI AM 640, live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Christmas in Southern California. Fake fireplaces, guest rooms filled with out-of-state relatives, and stimulating talk.
KFI.
KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
It may work. I'm Jennifer Jones Lee, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. Moderna says its booster shot appears to provide protection against the Omicron variant. The company says the booster is shown in studies of people on people who got the third shot had 37 times more neutralizing antibodies. Moderna CEO says the company is also working on an Omicron-specific booster shot. Dr. Fauci says the U.S. should expect to see an increase in breakthrough COVID-19 cases because of how easily the Omicron variant is spreading.
It has an extraordinary capability of transmitting efficiently from person to person. It seems to be overtaking all the other variants, including Delta, with a doubling time of about 2 to 3 days.
Fauci says the Omicron strain has 50 different mutations, which is unprecedented for a COVID variant. He says Omicron will quickly surpass Delta to become the dominant strain in the U.S. News is brought to you by the Cunning Dental Group. People in San Marino are being told to stay inside to avoid the smell from hundreds of gallons of gas that spilled into the Alhambra Wash. Officials say the spill happened yesterday afternoon when a car crashed into a pump at a gas station in Pasadena. This guy tells KTLA he's considering getting a hotel because of the fumes.
It's literally like smelling gas out of a gas can, like, nonstop. It's definitely annoying, but it's everywhere. It's the entire neighborhood. The smell gets inside your house.
Teamwork overnight to clean up the spill. Closing arguments have started in Minneapolis in the trial of an ex-police officer charged with killing an unarmed black man. Kim Potter says everything was chaotic when she was trying to arrest Dante Wright during a traffic stop last April. Instead of her taser. Potter's facing manslaughter charges, which carry a maximum sentence of 15 years. Closing arguments have started in Glenn Maxwell's sex trafficking trial. Her defense case at the end of last week, and Maxwell chose not to testify. She's been accused of grooming 4 underage girls to be sexually abused by the late Jeffrey Epstein and others. Maxwell is facing 80 years in prison if she's convicted on the 6 charges against her. More than 40 people on board a Royal Caribbean cruise that ended in Miami over the weekend tested positive for COVID-19 during that trip. The company says nearly all of the infected travelers were fully vaccinated, and the group was quarantined immediately after the positive test came back. Disney and Google have reached a deal to return Disney-owned content to YouTube TV, ABC, ESPN, Freeform, and other Disney channels were taken off the platform Friday as negotiations continued between the two, but an agreement was reached yesterday, and the Disney content has returned to YouTube shortly after. Dominated the weekend box office with the third biggest opening weekend in history. The movie earned $253 million in its debut weekend in the U.S. and Canada. The film was expected to make around $150 million.
We've got your drive on the 118.
Yeah, won't be making that much here on the 118, but just a heads up for you, going through Porter Ranch, eastbound 118 or Reseda. Seems the driver lost control of some sort. They wound up on the right side embankment, so I'm sure there's going to be a lot of activity. Again, that's eastbound 118 in Reseda. Not a major backup to warn you about, so just be careful. Westbound drive now, San Fernando Valley into Simi. It's in good shape. Rest of the San Fernando Valley, east 101, a little slow east of Tampa. That's not too bad. And south 405 from Sherman Way. Once you get past Sunset, very easy drive to LAX. Nothing easy about the 605. You just joined us. It's been going on for hours. 605, a little bit north of Washington. We've got lanes blocked on both sides of the freeway. The northbound 605, it's just jammed coming up from the 105, southbound coming up from the 10. If you can get on the north 605 at Whittier and get on the southbound side of Washington, you have a problem. And on your way, I'll keep you updated on this one. It's a bad one. KFI in the sky helps get you that faster. I'm Jeff Baugh.
The world of sports continues to be disrupted by COVID-19. Yesterday's Rams-Seattle Seahawks game was postponed until tomorrow at 4. LA has about 24 players on the COVID reserve list right now. In hockey...